Jen Bodies Alive from KHON2 News. Right now, so far today, it's been a fairly peaceful day. We've had at least 20 arrests. People were taken and cited for obstruction. Now there's been a shift change in the law enforcement, and it seems that police are... The tone is really changed here. Police are trying to clear the road. They are now lining the street. Sheriffs are coming from the top of Mauna Kea Access Road. Many of the people who were earlier cited or have already arrived back here on Mauna Kea Access Road. But again, the tone has completely changed. It is much, much different. They're currently moving one of the barriers that the Kia'i had placed here about 2 days ago. You can also see that many of the Kia'i have linked hands in front of this circle. They're telling us as media to stay off of the roadway, so we are not allowed to go onto the road. You can see officers lining, and you can see the other officers on the other side, again, removing that bamboo barrier that's been there for the past 2 days. We are here live on Mauna Kea Access Road, and this is exactly what's going on. They are trying to clear the roadway in order to begin construction that the governor had said was supposed to start on Monday. The Kia'i, the protectors of Mauna Kea, have been here at least since Friday, many of them, standing their ground, blocking the road and preventing that from happening. It's been a fairly civil and respectful negotiation up to this point, but the tone is changing, and I think police are taking a slightly different approach to this. We have many of the people who have come here who are opposed to TMT sitting along the roadway. There are hundreds of people here. Many of them have been here since around 3 o'clock this morning. And then still more have been here, like I said, since Friday. Roughly 20 to 30 arrests. And you can see all of the officers lining Mauna Kea Access Road. I don't know how many are here. We've asked DLNR, DoCare, as well as law enforcement numerous times how many officers have been brought over, how many are here. They won't answer us. They say that it's a matter of law enforcement, and they won't answer our questions in regard to how many law enforcement are here. Sheriffs, as we move towards... I think that's dangerous. Better off even standing. We're moving towards the tent. Kapu'aloha, everyone in the blue shorts are the Kapu'aloha. They're helping to kind of keep guard for those who are protecting, to just keep a safe space. You see the tents and a crowd of people at the center of Mauna Kea Access Road with linked hands, and it looks like they are refusing to leave. I got it. We're walking past the tents here. And as you can see, just beyond the tent, we have sheriffs. Sheriffs standing in a line. And on the other side of the tent, we have police officers and Kia'i and many others and Kupuna, some still sitting underneath the tent here. And at least two rows. On this side, you see at least two rows of people with linked hands.
Cool.
along Mauna Kea Access Road. This is day three. This is day three of the standoff between the Kia'i, the protectors of Mauna Kea, and law enforcement. And we have Uncle John again. Uncle John, they took you away and you're right back here. Can you tell me what's happening right now?
I really don't know what's happening, but they're sending another department of officers to get the kupunas, the rest of the kupunas. So right now we're just protecting them for they're getting hard time for get the kupunas, the rest of the kupunas. But if not, as time go on, the darkness come, then able to drive up the big machines up in the night. So we're trying to protect the road and help the kupunas over here so they don't get taken away that quickly.
I know that we've been told that law enforcement don't care. They just want the road cleared at this point. So what happens if they come in and start arresting everyone that's blocking the road?
Well, we'd be right back. And that's what we have to say. It's only a paper, and that paper is only a temporary paper. And we gotta go court September 28th. Everybody at the same date. But right now we're just blocking off the road for time.
What kind of impact do you think this is making today?
It's making one big impact for the government so they can open their eyes and listen. And because you can get more people from around the island, around the world, be coming over here to support what we're doing to save Mauna Kea.
How long can this go on?
Can go in for weeks, can go in for months, can go in for 20 years. But this is not the end. Like I say, we be back. I'm back. And with more energy, more mana, and happiness. Because we get more people coming to support Mauna Kea.
If they come to take you away again, will you go?
Yes, I will. Like I say, it's over again, same thing. And no matter what they do, the officers, they hate to do these, you know, but they see the same faces back again, year after year, after year, after years.
Road on the third day of the standoff, but many of these Kia'i protectors of Mauna Kea have been here since Friday. Early this morning, the arrests started before 8 a.m. The first person arrested was Billy Freitas. He laid his body on the line and forced the officers to lift him and carry him into the van to be taken away to be arrested. And then lines and lines of kupuna followed him, at least 20. There were at least 4 to 5 full vans that were driven away of kupuna that were sighted. And many of them came right back. Some of them are right back on the road here to continue to protect Mauna Kea. Now, the energy has changed here on the mountain since earlier this morning. It was much calmer. There was a lot of tension. We knew there were going to be arrests. But things ramped up a little bit in the shift change. The law enforcement that had been negotiating with the Kia'i for the peaceful and respectful arrest are now changing shift. So this seems like a new shift that's come in. More law enforcement, more sheriffs. So that's what we're seeing. Police are lining the road. Sheriffs are lining the back blocking anyone from going further back, and we've been told they want to clear the road, and that is their objective today. So we will definitely see more arrests. We can take you down to a different area. There are hundreds and hundreds of people here. They've been here, many of them. Many drove in since 3 o'clock this morning. Cars line at Daniel K. Inouye. They're making an announcement.
We are conducting a law enforcement operation. So long as you peacefully protest and stay off the road, we will not take action. Please do not interfere with us.
So as you heard, law enforcement are alerting the crowd that as long as they stay off of Mauna Kea Access Road, they will not be arrested, which basically means anyone who remains on the road will likely be arrested. And right now we have two lines of, it looks like at least 20 people with many, many others seated behind them, and then a tent full of kupuna. So they're giving everyone fair warning to remove themselves from the road if they do not want to be arrested.
All your energy to look at those mana right on me. Look at those tiny. Your kupuna is still under the tent.
Would you like to talk to us?
Well, I already talked to my hair. I don't want to clash. But I love your stitch.
Not to clash. It's just one more thing. Like, real quick,
too
it's
hard.
Just a little.
It's
I know.
It's just
that's
too much.
That's what everyone needs to see.
But I come from a different group. I come from Kea.
Auntie Deborah, can we talk to you for just a little bit?
How do you know my name?
I watched them take you into the van. I think one of your nephews was right there. And
I requested for my cousins, both Nino, Kamakau, and Ka'anoi, Kealoha, Nai'a. That's a family of ours in Ola'a, Yang. If you're going to take me out, you take me as Ohana, not as sheriff of DMA. You take me out as an Ohana member, because I'm Hawaiian first. I'm a Hawaiian woman first, and in our ancient culture, it was the woman who was supreme, not the man. Kiokulani, highest chiefess and regent of this land, Kahumanu, favorite wife of Kamehameha I, Kahi Paea. It was the woman. Get it right. We are the mothers of this earth. Without us, nobody is born. Get it right. But I am a Hawaiian woman. I stand for what I am. Can we agree to disagree? Sometimes we have to. But today I'm here for Keakua, for my cousin who I brought home 23 years ago, Henry Opukai. I brought his Evie from Cornwall, Connecticut, after he'd been dead for 175 years. The Keakua said, get up, it's time for him to come home. 23 years ago. On my birthday, we buried him at Kaikoulu Congregational Church, August 15, 1993. You want to talk to me? Come off the camera. Yes, I give you all you want. Off the camera. The same flight.
Thank you.
What you're witnessing now is the unity of the Hawaiian community. The unity of the Hawaiian community.
Again, if you're just joining us, we are here live at the base of Mauna Kea on Mauna Kea Access Road. For the standoff, we're in day three.
We have been stepped on as Hawaiians all the way up.
There have been at least 24 arrests earlier today. And now police are mining Mauna Kea Access Road. Sheriffs are standing towards the upper portion of Mauna Kea Access Road, and groups of people have linked arms and are standing blocking the roadway, which the LNR has told us they need cleared. Hundreds and hundreds of people have gathered here to protest TMT, opposed to what's happening. They're putting in earplugs. They may use a sound weapon, the LRAD.
from the crowd. We have been told that DOCARE obtained the LRAD, which has been a source of contention for Kia'i. They were afraid that it would be utilized to disperse the crowd. It has been known to be used as a form of crowd control in other protests across the country and the world. We currently don't see it. However, it's a very, very powerful sound device, we're told. And with everyone putting in earplugs, law enforcement pulling in earplugs, we are guessing that they are probably getting ready to use the LRAD. We currently don't see it, but that does not necessarily mean that it's not here. It could be that they just want better communication between the law enforcement, but knowing that DOCARE does have an LRAD, is cause for concern for those of us that are here in the crowd. Center of the crowd, just in front of the two lines with everyone linked hands, are Andre Perez and Koho'okahi Kanoha. They have been two of the outspoken voices coordinating and negotiating with law enforcement up to this point. Right now, it looks as though everyone is just waiting for the next move. It's hard to tell what law enforcement may do next. But it is clear that neither side intends to back down. We have been asked to remain off of the road, and law enforcement has warned everyone here, if they do not wish to be arrested, to remain on the side. Yesterday we were told during a press conference by the state that the road, Mauna Kea Access Road, is connected by, or excuse me, controlled by Department of Transportation. But this is Department of Hawaiian Homeland's land. Okay, it looks like Koho'okahi Kanoha is, I'm not sure if they're negotiating or talking. It looks like he is with the sheriff. Unfortunately, I can't hear what they're saying, but we're hoping that this is a good sign.
Loving our mo'opuna is not a crime.
earlier today, we had seen more than two dozen Kupuna arrested. And now here, we see lines and lines of Keiki, the next generation of protectors, standing their ground, linking hands. Many of them are the children of the people that were arrested earlier. Many of them are family. And they are choosing to take a stand to protect the rest of their kupuna, many of them that have returned back to the road after being arrested earlier today. And right in front of us, we see our Uncle Walter Riddy. He has stood for the Hawaiian people in many causes for many, many years. O'olawe, as well as here on Mauna Kea. He was taken away earlier, cited along with many other kupuna, and as you can see, he's back. He's back standing alongside them.
All of our ohana survives for us to thrive as people, to thrive as Hawaiians, to live our culture, to care for our aina.
Look at our faces. Look in my eyes as an old woman. Are you ready to put your weapons on me? Then do it. Do it. Shoot me down. Lace me down. Whatever. Not my children. Me as an old woman. Do it. Not my openness.
It's very emotional here. It's been a very emotional day for everyone here.
And they don't like the Kamis, the Tutus is Kamis.
There are Kamis of a many ways. And
we have a life of Bolanes, but they are Kamis.
Coldness in their hearts. Like God said, forgive them, for they not know what they do. That's what he said before he was crucified. And that's what they want to do to us, is crucify us. Shed a tear for us.
Everybody gonna make a stand.
Shed a tear for you two over here.
We make this.
Come on. Shed a tear. Take off your dark glasses and look into my eyes. Look into my eyes. Come on. My dear. What have we done to you, brother?
Aloha.
my eyes as an old woman. Don't arrest my mauponas. Arrest me. Give me a tear that you love us. We love you, Capiz. We have no weapons on us. But our poor boy. Why you won't stand with me, your tutu. Stand with me, your tutu. What have I done to all of you? Tell me. Please, somebody tell me. What have I done to you?
They're not Hawaiian.
They are Hawaiians. They are Kanaka Maoli. They are Hawaiians.
Everybody,
if not them, the Keiki will be on our side. So Malama, Kapu Aloha, don't give them any reason.
I have fought for you both on Kaho'olawe. I have saved our island people and your children's children. Now fight with us to save the Mauna. William Isla don't own the mountain. God does. Governor Yigi don't own the Mauna.
Eric, I've got Koho'okahi Kanuha. Koho'okahi, can you tell me, was there any resolution in the negotiations or the conversation you had with the sheriff?
No, there's no resolution. There's no negotiation to this. Obviously, they're coming in much, much stronger force. As you can see, they got batons, they got guns, they got mace, they got pepper spray. They got the LRAD over there. So they brought out their toys. So for us, there's no negotiation. We just remain committed in Kapu Aloha. We remain committed in peaceful, nonviolent protest because we know these guys are not bad people. They don't want to hurt us. They don't want to do anything bad to us. They've been forced in this position by their superiors, people who are making them victims of occupation and of genocide and of denationalization. These people are our ohana. We're going to see them in our communities. I'm going to see Uncle on the beach one day. I'm going to see Brada at the store one day. I'm going to see that guy over there in the library one day. These are our people. So we just got to remain Kapu Aloha. If they choose to take us out, they're going to choose to take us out. But we know that we are doing this for them. We're doing this for their keiki. We're doing this for their mo'opuna. Because we know one day they're going to be with us. They're going to leave them a better future. And they can do whatever they want and try to prevent us from doing that. But we are doing this for the keiki. We're doing this for our lahui. And we're going to do whatever we got to do. They can bring it all. But we know why we're doing it. They know why we're doing it. So we'll see what they do.
Thank you. That's Koho'okahi Kanuha, again, one of the outspoken young Kia'i here, sharing his mana'o.
I will fight to the
Hundreds and hundreds of people here in opposition of TMT. All of them here wanting to protect Mauna Kea, trying to prevent the desecration of a place they consider sacred, a place where many of their kupuna and ohana are buried. Here in front of us is Uncle Billy Freitas. He was the first to be arrested today. He laid his body on the line, and he's back. He's back.
Come on.
We are conducting a law enforcement operation. So long as you peacefully protest, stay off the road, we will not take action. Please do not interfere with us. We are conducting a law enforcement operation.
I gotta be with my wife. So if I don't get arrested again, I don't go again. But I want you guys to promise, don't do anything to go wrong. Mauna Kea already gonna take care of
me. Law enforcement operation. Okay. Our law. Okay. 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 Please do not interfere with me.
So they do have the LRAD. It is actually in the center of the road behind the officers.
You guys are not like this. I know that for a fact. I am older than you guys. I see the love that you have for it. Show it. Give us a smile. You weren't born like this. Smile. Cry for us. You're not going to get fired. I promise you guys.
Come this side.
Look at us. Look at our children over there, our younger generation.
In case you're just joining us, we are live on Mauna Kea Access Road at the base of Mauna Kea. This is day 3 of the standoff. Roughly before 8 o'clock in the morning, law enforcement started arrests. The first to go was Billy Freitas, and followed by at least 24 other kupuna. They were cited for obstructing a government project. But many of them returned very quickly. Now, a little while ago, I believe there was a shift change, and the whole mood really changed here. Since that time, additional law enforcement were brought in, and they are currently lining the road on either side. behind these lines of Kia'i who are linking hands in solidarity, and who I'm told do not intend to leave, is a group of people seated. Behind that is a tent full of kupuna and others who do not intend to leave the roadway. And behind that is a line of sheriffs that are in a straight line across Mauna Kea Access Road. So right now, many of these Kia'i protectors are blocked on either side by law enforcement. We have not been told how many law enforcement. They will not divulge that to us. We've asked numerous times, but there's quite a few here. There's also hundreds and hundreds of Kia'i protectors of Mauna Kea. Many of them have been here since Friday. Many of them just came today. But all of them are here for one thing, and that is protect Mauna Kea. It's been, a lot has gone on over the last 3 days. The first day was primarily the Department of Transportation sort of securing Daniel K. Inouye Highway. They had lined the highway about 800 feet on either side of Mauna Kea Access Road with cement barriers. They tell us it was to, pardon me, a lot of people here. It's difficult for us to see on either side of us when we're talking. They lined the road with cement barriers, they say for safety reasons, so people don't continue to cross the street. But also it's for crowd control. Right across the street from us is the Pu'uhonua, and that was deemed the Pu'uhonua, or City of Refuge, a safe place for protesters to stay during this event. Many of them have been here since Friday, since Saturday, since Sunday. There was a 12-hour vigil held here on Sunday with a Hawaiian protocol ceremony at every hour. It was meant to cleanse the land. And you can hear the crowd singing. I have to tell you, it's pretty powerful standing here. It's pretty. And one of the Kia'i standing want to remind everyone that it's not just Hawaiians here. There are people of every ethnicity that are here standing in solidarity. Filipinos, Japanese, Portuguese, Hawaiian, many Caucasians, many that live here, many were born and raised here, many that have only been here a couple of years, anyone that feels a connection to try to prevent the desecration of the land and to prevent TNT. System. It is not an LRAD in the center, which is good news if that is correct.
KHON!
I think we're live.
We're live. We're live. You're live.
We are live.
See, this has been an emotional day, I think, for everyone. Can you tell me what this is like for you?
What else can I tell you?
What needs to happen? What needs to happen?
What needs to happen? That they dismount. They go home and you tell William Isla to tell his boys, come home. No need, come over here and arrest us Hawaiians. If you compare this handsome man to me, look at his wardrobe and my wardrobe. What the difference do we have? A lot of difference. But underneath their uniforms, they have a heart, they have koko, they have tears, they have ohana, just like me.
I gotta go home after all of this. I have to go home all after all of this to go feed my animals. Maybe they have animals. I have to feed my family like they have to feed their family. We are no different. We're the same. Right? We are the same. Why all this? Why? What have we done, like I said before? Is it so wrong to protect our Mauna? Is it so wrong to step on our beneficiary's road, which is this, is our trust roads? What is the matter? What did we do wrong? If I am a criminal, then arrest me, okay? Okay? Arrest me if I'm a criminal. I have not done any crime, but to protect the Mauna, like I protected in 1977, I was arrested. But that's our island. This is our Mauna. This is our land. They standing on my property as a beneficiary. This is Hawaiian Homes. I don't understand. Where do we go? Where do we stand? We can't stand there. We'll interrupt their arrest. Where else do we go? Where? They're taking our ocean. They're taking our Mauna. They're poisoning our foods. What else are they gonna do? Look at these gear. Look at my gear. Nothing but old clothes. Old clothes. I don't have an LRAD on me. I don't have spray on me. I am just an old woman. Who even this can be my mōpuna? This can be my mōpuna. If they were, I would tell them, you take off that and you go home with tutu. And puli in the ear. But they stand for something that's not worth anything to the Kanaka Maoli people. And if people don't want me to say anything, e kalamai. In 10 years, I will be underground, and I cannot see this go on for our mōpunas over there. We have fought the military. We have fought Iggy. We have fought fighting William Island now. Who the hell else are we gonna fight? Mea Kim, we fighting them. What else more? Print this. Don't you leave anything out for the world to hear.
We're live,
Auntie.
We're live, you're hearing all of it.
Okay?
You're hearing all of it.
We're live to Hawaii.
Where do we go? Where do we go? Our lands are being stolen. Our EVs are being pushed on the side. Our EVs. No respect for the kupuna. What happens? What happens to all of you if they take out the LRAD right now and they tear gas and they spray anti with no protection? Who's going to be responsible for my death? You tell me, but I will stand, I will kue. I will kue. Bring out all your weapons and all your insect sprayers or what, but you can never bring down this tutu. Never! Never! We're tired. Enough is enough.
It's a very simple
solution. We just gotta clarify status and the law. And the public record is all there. It's just that no one's clarifying status or title. All we have to do is spend a little bit of time and clarify the title of Rwanda. That's it. No title, no jurisdiction. But there's something deeper spiritually that's going on for all the people. Just clarify, okay, everyone knows Hawaiian Kingdom is in continuity. Everybody knows, we all have been served notice. And just because we've been served notice, if people don't respond, if they don't answer and rebut all the claims you make, point for point, they're in dishonor. We don't even get any respect verbally, let the character of writing down your claim and your evidence and then presenting it for lawful adjudication. The problem is lawful adjudication is impossible in the state of Hawaii because it's a corporation. It has its own Dun & Bradstreet number. The whole of America is a corporation, officially announced in 1871, District of Columbia. So we're not under the Creator's Law, even though the Hawaiian Kingdom was founded on the Creator's Law in 1839, Declaration of Rights. And in America, 1776, Declaration of Independence. So the same law that covers the earth is actually the law of this soil. We're not adjudicating controversy on this soil in the proper venue. And the venue is where Hawaiian Kingdom is in continuity. So what we're doing is, now that the world is paying attention, we're going to educate our people how law really works. Not corporate procedure, but actual common law, natural law, presentment, and adjudication.
What is your name?
I'm Gene Tamashiro. I'm a sovereign Hawaiian. I'm living lawfully in my own country. Hawaiian Kingdom is not a corporation. The whole world has been covered by this corporate matrix under false presumption. Okay, so harm is being done on a false presumption. What true Kanakas do is clarify status and the law. And that's how we can examine all claims respectfully and also the evidence. That's what needs to be done. I'm not a lawyer. I'm not a British accreditation regency foreign agent. I'm a true Kanaka, and God created people not to practice law and pay hundreds of thousands of dollars to lawyers to represent you in the practice of law. We are all built to know what is pono. We are all required to live lawfully, and there's a process to do that.
Thank you so much,
God
Gene.
Bless you.
Thank you so
Thanks
much,
for your time.
Gene.
Appreciate
Thank you
it.
So much.
Okay. Good luck. Appreciate
Thank
that. You. I hope you can do something.
Ikuma, 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 ik
If you're just joining us, we are still streaming live on the base of Mauna Kea, on Mauna Kea Access Road. Again, this is day three of the standoff between the Kia'i protectors of Mauna Kea and law enforcement. I think possibly an hour and a half ago, the mood here changed, and additional law enforcement rolled in, and they have since been standing on either side of Mauna Kea Access Road, and we've been told to stay on the side of the road and not obstruct their way. If we don't want to be arrested, we need to stay on the side of Mauna Kea Access Road. Just beyond them is two lines of the next generation of Kia'i. Many of them ohana and children and grandchildren of the kupuna that were earlier arrested today. At least a dozen kupuna were arrested and cited for obstruction, taken away, and still many of them came back. Beyond that line is another group of people who they too are ready to go. Beyond that, underneath the tent, more people, more Kia'i, more protectors who are ready to stand, who do not want TMT, who are trying to protect Mauna Kea. It's been a very long and emotional day for everyone. If you've been watching, you've seen many of our kupuna, many of the Kia'i share their thoughts. We've been here since 3 o'clock this morning. Not quite as long as the Kia'i, but it's been a long day, a very emotional day for everyone here. And it does not seem that either side is ready to relent, ready to walk away. They both sides, I believe, are ready to stand here. They've told me as long as it takes. We had a press conference with DLNR, and they had mentioned that they will continue to arrest people, the police will continue to arrest people, until construction can begin. And the Kia'i have told me they are ready to be arrested, and that they will continue to come back for as long as necessary. For a day, for weeks, for months, for years. They are telling me, the Kia'i, and many of them who have been the outspoken leaders here, have told me they will continue to do this as long as it takes, until Governor Ige halts this, stops this, and stops TMT. We have continued to get more comment from TMT regarding this. Hopefully they will talk to us and give a statement. Right now, I don't know anyone official here that is willing to talk to me on camera that can explain the plan or anything. I think think we're going to take a little bit of a break here because it's been quite a while, and I give some serious props to my photographer, Eric Bathan, holding this very heavy camera, handheld all the way. So props to him. I think we need to take a pause just to take a breather. We're not going anywhere, but just so that he can rest his shoulder and his back, we will continue coverage. So please don't go anywhere. We will keep you posted on what's happening here. If they continue arresting people, we will let you know. If things escalate, we will let you know. Jen Boni's alive for KHON2 News. We just need to take a little break right now. Thank you for tuning in. We'll be back.